Patrick, good morning. How are you?
I'm doing great. Great to be back.
Thank you for being here once more for the Dan podcast. I know we had a talk some time ago and we were discussing many things. There was some things that we couldn't discuss at that time, right? But now we can. You just released a very important new product for the dive market that is probably, in my opinion, going to change safety for diving.
We hope so.
And it's the Descent S1 Buoy. And you're here today. Thank you for being here with us to talk about this new mark in the diving segment.
Yeah, thanks for the invite back. Always a pleasure to be back talking with Dan. Since we spoke last time, mm-hmm. we have launched a brand new product, the Descent S1 Buoy, which we hope will go a long way in adding utility and safety to divers. It's been a project that's been a long time in the works at Garmin, so it's been exciting to get that announced and launched and give you guys a little bit of a taste of it here recently as we went through the demo process.
Yes, no, it was very interesting. We were diving with it yesterday, and it's amazing. And believe me, we were trying to use it as much as we could, sending messages back and forth and trying to break it, right?
Yeah.
Going into obstructions to see if it would stop work, and it worked perfectly. It was
great.
Very, very nice dive, and having the ability to, at the whole dive, see all the divers around us, their air consumption, and the location of the buoy, always having the bearing for the buoy, was really, really different, really amazing to have this. And it's one thing that I can tell you, right? More than 20 years as a dive physician, most of this time associated with Dan, and we have a lot of instances, unfortunately, several stories of divers getting lost or divers running out of air underwater. And I think this product can really put a dent on this statistics. It's something that really, really helps. Topside, having the whole dive team, air consumption and location at the whole time, and having the dive master or whoever's leading the group knowing how's everyone there without having to ask, without having to go to the person.
Yes.
It's something that really, it's really amazing.
We're excited to put another tool in the toolbox for the dive community, whether you're a small dive team or whether you're a charter operator, you're teaching a class, you have some sort of mission-oriented aspect to your dive, scientific dive or military, commercial. The ability to have situational awareness of what's going on in the water from a surface perspective, not just to monitor, but to interact with the divers. So as you mentioned, being able to sit up top and have a simple view of where the divers are, what their depth is, what their tank pressure is, what their distance away, being able to message back and forth with the divers, whether it's safety related, mission related, it really adds a net new approach to monitoring divers and diver safety from topside. And then, as you mentioned, in the water, it provides some new tools that I think divers will appreciate.
Yeah,
I now have a pointer to get me back home, to get me back to the anchor line, get me back to the entry near exit point. It extends the range of being able to communicate with my dive team. So we do hope that it's a combination of really essential utility and what we hope will be essential safety value for the divers moving forward. It was exciting to have you guys in the water yesterday with it, both underwater and topside, to sort of see that in action, because I think it is such a new type of product for the dive industry that I think it will take a little while for people to figure out how do I incorporate this into my dive strategy, my dive planning. And I think seeing it kind of starts to get the gears turning. So it was exciting to have the Dan team in the water yesterday. You talked a little bit about your impressions, but I'm interested in kind of your thoughts around how you see this maybe influencing kind of diving from your perspective.
Yeah, no, I think it's really, it's a mark on safety, right? Mm-hmm. Because we tend, by being Dan, we tend to look at the safety side of things, right? The safety functions. We knew it was coming. We did the beta test.
Seen it since the early beta testing days. Yes.
Our research team did the beta testing, and we knew it was coming. But seeing now the commercial version, right, the market version, really, at least for me, it was really eye-opening. And not having to rely, for instance, right, recalling divers when we're diving. Traditionally, we bang on the ladder, we rev the engine of the boat, or more advanced operations, they have some kind of siren underwater or something like that, right? But it's not very reliable. I was in diving situations before that I couldn't hear the recalling, and you have an emergency on the boat, you have a diver in need of being evacuated immediately, and you have to wait for the other divers in the water. Having this ability to blast a communication, blast a message to all the divers, calling them back to the boat, is amazing. This is very, very interesting.
And then, you know, being able topside to send that message and then see the response, understand. Acknowledgement. Okay. Yep, yes, I got that response. And then being able to see them returning, to see their depth. If it's a group of technical divers, allow them to send back up their time to surface.
Exactly.
You can start building those plans, kind of more thoughtfully around whatever the situation might be topside. Yeah. So, yeah,
I'm clearing deco. I still have 5 minutes.
Exactly.
I did send one of those 10 minutes to the end of the dive, so it was very nice to really interact and use the system.
And as you mentioned, the DAN team has been really helpful with the product development as we put it into beta, and allowed you guys to kind of get in the water, start to provide us feedback on how to make the product better. That was a super essential part of our product development process. This is a product that's been in the pipeline for a long time. It's a complicated product to make, simple for the divers to use, simple for topside to use. So that feedback has been really essential for us as we've refined the product to a point where now we've launched it, and we're excited to get it in the hands of divers.
Yeah, I can imagine the complexity. I was at some point of the dive, I was looking around all the divers in the water, and I was imagining all the communications back and forth with the buoy with topside, and I was like, wow, it's amazing how much information are going back and forth between everyone. And you can text your dive buddy directly, so it's not something that it's just you and the buoy, it's you and your people in the water with you. But there was one thing that I was looking afterwards when we were debriefing, right? I was with Frauke, our VP of research, and we were discussing the heat maps. Mm-hmm. So how it maps your dive, right? So that thing for us would be very important for research. We do very consistent dives when we're doing our research protocols. We'll do very consistent dives, and note all the waypoints of the dive and do all of this. With these two, we can do it afterwards in the app. We can see exactly what was done and if it was in accordance with the protocol or not, and it would, even for research, will be a very important tool for us.
It's one of the other benefits of this as the S1 are tracking the divers throughout their dive. It's collecting their location data. It's collecting how much time they're spending in particular places. And after that diver surfaces, it's pushing that data to their dive computer and then ultimately up to their log in the Garmin dive app, and showing you this heat map of where they've been through the dive, how much time they've spent in various areas. So even if there's not a topside, you know, kind of a surface support situation, that S1's still adding value, allowing you to have a marker for how to return back to your entry exit point, and a mechanism just to track your dives. You're getting back a track log, in essence, of where you've been on your dives. You can understand where you've been, where you might want to return to. Hey, I missed this spot that I might want to check out. Or to your point, I saw something that was sort of a central part of my dive plan. You know, did I hit that as expected, or where do I need to go back to? So, yeah.
And the tasks, right? Task one completed.
Yes.
Proceed to the next one. So this type of communication will really help us a lot.
The messaging piece is really interesting. We talked about this a little bit yesterday, where it's difficult to anticipate.
And I was the chatty one, right?
The Dan team was quite chatty in the water yesterday. And that's a good thing, right? But, testing out the various messaging options in there, it's really hard to create a very simple, clean, efficient interface, but also create a robust set of messaging options. So you have messages that are very appropriate for a small buddy team just for basic safety and communication. Then you have more of the mission-oriented or the task-oriented dive scenarios that you want to provide, location or task routing, along the way. And so we provide some options to prioritize which messages are going to be most important for the type of dive that you're doing. And yeah, the Dan team was doing a great job putting those through the ringer yesterday.
It was funny because we didn't have names. We configured just the colors, orange one, orange two. And when we came out of the water, someone asked, "Oh, who's orange one?" I said, "Myself."
You and Frauke, I think, were the chattiest ones.
Who's orange too? Frauke.
Yep. But it's great, right? It gives you a sense of how I think effective communication in the water, both diver to diver and diver to surface, can be in understanding that situational awareness, kind of guiding the dive along through the process. And whether it's task or safety, oriented, how you get done.
And we were operating under the little devil on the shoulder too. Let's break it.
The Dan team, one of the things I've appreciated about the Dan engagement on our S1 is very much around, how do I push this thing to the limits? Put some stress on the system? Because it is a complex system, as you mentioned, and we need that. We need that feedback. And Dan's been a great partner there.
And this segue perfectly to the part that I want to discuss. We were visiting your office here in Cary, North Carolina, yesterday, and it was the first time I was in any Garmin office, and I was pretty impressed. So I was impressed with, of course, the technology, but we know that, we know the brand, we know what you guys do. It was surprising for me to see the office yesterday and to see how aligned with us you are, how passionate about what you do, everyone there. Every single person in your team, diver, even the marketing people, all of them divers and very adamant about the product and the safety and the reliability of the product. And we saw the testing equipment there, the interference chamber, and all those things. For me, it was amazing to see how everyone is so passionate about, and how similar to what we do here in this building here at DAN, you guys are. And it was very pleasantly surprised.
It's been amazing as we've grown the dive business to have the ability to have grown the team, especially here in Cary. And Cary is one of our core R&D teams for dive specifically. And the facilities we have here, the labs, whether it's reliability testing, kind of testing our sonar, going through all the RF interference, our mechanical reliability testing, the facilities here are specifically tuned to how do we take an idea, how do we build it, how do we put some stress on it, and then sort of prove it out for continued R&D. And more and more of our products these days from a dive perspective are largely developed here out of the Cary area, with support certainly from our global teams back at headquarters. But it's a super important thing. We have such a passionate group. The people that we have here, not just in Cary and at Garmin in general, but especially here nearby you guys in Cary, is we've got a passionate group of divers. We have dive instructors. We have everywhere from very experienced divers to new divers. One of the things I enjoy the most is creating new divers inside the Garmin community. But yeah, everyone from marketing to product support to sales, and certainly through our engineering team. It's one of the benefits of having some of the facilities like Fantasy Lake nearby, mm-hmm. where yeah. we can get a big group of divers from the engineering teams in the water. You know, we talked a little bit about proving something out in our test facilities on site, taking it out to one of the local lakes for some more testing, and then ultimately getting it in the water, whether it's Fantasy Lake for some more controlled tests, or go take it offshore, North Carolina, out on the Outer Banks, and putting it through some more tests. So it this location has also provided a really great option for finding great people who are passionate divers and making it a home for creating amazing dive products.
As long as you guys continue to invite us to join,
well, and
we have to organize some wreck diving or something here in our coast.
The proximity to Dan and a lot of other great research institutions here and the Raleigh-Durham area is just amazing, right? So,
it's nice.
Having the Dan team nearby is something we will continue to take advantage of.
Thank you for that. And yeah, it was a pleasure this last couple days. Interacting with you guys, with everyone, and knowing this groundbreaking new product, and it's definitely something that I was talking with Frauke at dinner yesterday, and I said, are we ordering one or two for the research team? We're just putting an order because it's really something that will help us. And it's something that I think it will really change. Once it's disseminated, it will really change statistics in terms of safety, which is all we are about, right?
Absolutely. Yeah. I think this is a product that as more and more people use it, we'll learn more and more use cases for how people are applying it to the diving challenges that they have, the diving scenarios that they have. And we're excited to continue to develop features for it to help make it more and more useful for diver utility and diver safety.
Great. It's always a pleasure to have you guys here. Thank you for this continuation of the last talk that we had. Thank you for bringing this product and to rely on us to help you develop on the beta testing part. And it's always a pleasure, and I think it's our mission, right, to mm-hmm. help and do whatever we can to improve diving safety. And I think Garmin's doing a lot on this sector, so we're proud and happy to be part of it.
Yeah, thanks again for the opportunity to join you today and over the last few days and in the water and on the surface with S1. And yeah, look forward to more partnership with Dan in the future to help make diving safer.
Great. Thank you so much.
Thank you.